Yo guys, welcome back to the Uncle Sharma channel, here to review Inter's 3-1 win against Bologna at home at the San Siro, taking revenge for last year's defeat by Bologna. It was a 2-1 loss that pretty much killed Inter's hope of the Scudetto, whereas this time we were clinical, we punished them, and yeah, it was a good performance overall. 3 wins in a row, that's the best streak Inter have had in the Serie A this season, which obviously wasn't hard to do. But you know, ever since we've switched back to the 3-5-2, Conte's put that 3-4-1-2 to the side, as 95% of the fan base was asking for, and look, lo and behold, the results are coming in. Inter looking a lot more solid, even though the one goal we did concede was an absolute brain fart once again from the defense, like a goal out of nothing, you know, a flick by Palacio, and then a pass into the middle, and then no one was there, and then Vignato, the 18-19-year-old, coming in to score. But apart from that, Inter really didn't concede that much. So once again, the 3-5-2, but it's not just the 3-5-2, the mentality in general, you know, we're not so exposed, we're not trying to press so high up. You know, the things that we've been seeing in the last few matches, this is what we want to see going into the match against the Shakhtar in the Champions League. We're expecting some rotation in the starting lineup, but Conte went with the starting three centre-back pairings or trio of Skriniar, De Vrij and Bastoni. Surprisingly, I thought D'Ambrosio or Ranocchia might come in to give a rest to some of them. They did come off in the second half. D'Ambrosio came on, so they did get a little bit of rest, but still surprised that they didn't get a bit more rest, because you know, I guess Bologna in theory shouldn't need those three to win. But you know, all in all, it was good. In the midfield, we got to see Vidal returning. He was okay today. He wasn't as good as he was against Sassuolo, but you know, does his work there. Gagliardini, another decent performance. You know, this guy is, he, apparently there's rumors of him winning or earning a new contract, a new deal. We can't beat this guy. This guy is just, you know, indestructible under Conte. You know, we know Conte just loves him, so not much we can do. But if he puts up performances like this where he's decent, we probably should have got a goal as well today. Hakimi laid him on perfectly, but he didn't quite get his feet right. But you know, can't criticize him when he plays like this. And then obviously Brozovic, as I said, since the 3-5-2 has come back, since the, you know, he's been put back into his real position. Like, it's not rocket science, putting players in their actual position. Brozovic's best position is that regista, CDM position. Ever since he's come back, you know, against Gladbach, he was man of the match. He was probably, you know, if it wasn't for Hakimi's 2 goal, he would be man of the match. Once again, perfect assist for Hakimi's first goal, you know, over the defense. The defensive line was not good in that goal, but still, that ball was really good to Hakimi on the run. Finally, someone else, apart from Sanchez, learning how to link up with Hakimi, bro. Like, what's going on? Why is no one understanding that you feed the ball to him into the space? And yeah, Brozovic did that. And obviously, I have to point it out, guys. Sorry, but I don't know if you guys saw it. Eriksen coming on in the 89th minute. Once again, the Eriksen bingo. But I'm laughing, but I actually want to cry. I feel sorry for the guy. I mean, look at what Conte's done to him. The hairline is gone. This guy's embraced the full boldness. He's trying to go, I don't know if he's trying to go full Wesley Schneider, Arjen Robben. Like, this guy, you know, we knew that, you know, hashtag hairline watch. He was struggling with his hairline. He's been holding on to that little bit at the front for a while. But look how depressed he looks, man. Like, look, what have we done to this guy, Christian Eriksen? Oh man, I feel so sorry for him, but it is what it is. And as I said, Hakimi, man of the match, 2 goals. Probably could have had an assist as well. Yeah, so good to see him, you know, get his confidence up. He probably could have been left on to, you know, get a hat-trick, you know, Conte being a little bit pragmatic there, but still, first goal was nice, you know, gonna run like a striker, you know, a striker would be proud of that run, running into the defence. And to finish it off with his weaker foot, which he did in the second one as well. In the second one, you know what it reminded me of? His second goal, which was beautiful, is the Guarin goal against AC Milan in the derby in 2014-15, I believe, in the Mancini season, when he cut in onto his left foot and did a beautiful whipped shot with his left foot. So yeah, Hakimi's goal was quite similar to that, not as much power, but so nicely taken, and he had to run in a lot more. He was right on the wing and he came in, no one stopped him. Poor defending by Bologna once again. But yeah, so good to see Hakimi. You know, as we said, as I said, give him time, guys. He's 21 years old. Like, you know, these criticisms that I started to see, obviously we know he needs to improve his defending, and you know, it seemed like his morale and confidence was a bit low, but this is exactly what he needed, this boost of morale. In the next match, probably Damian still probably deserves to start, but we'll see. So happy for Hakimi, man. My Maghrebi bowler, the Tajin Maicon. Credit once again to Perisic on the left-hand side as well. I said against Sassuolo, it was probably his best performance as a left wing-back, and today was another solid performance. He's starting to actually look like a wing-back. You know, the movements he makes in terms of tracking runners and being in position, he looks like he's finally, you know, got those in his system. You know, he doesn't really get beaten 1v1, or he hasn't really been challenged, to be honest. But yeah, he got an assist, or I don't think he got credited for the assist because the first attempt by Lukaku was stopped, and then Lukaku took it again for his goal. But yeah, that was pretty much, I would count that as an assist because he got that ball in. And Lukaku, the way he bodied Tomiyasu, we've seen that so many times with Lukaku, he's an absolute beast. What can a defender really do? And Tomiyasu is quite a big guy as well for a, you know, Japanese guy. But he just got ragdolled out of the way and took another nice goal for Lukaku. This guy just keeps on scoring, can't stop scoring. Sanchez was also decent next to him, not as good as he was against Sassuolo, but you know, still good. Lautaro got some minutes at the end, but yeah, overall good team performance. Another 3 points, you know, staying up there, second in position after Juve's struggled win against Torino. But you know, keeping the momentum going into the Shakhtar match feeling positive. Hakimi, man of the match for me. Let me know your man of the match in the comments below, and make sure to leave a like for the Inter performance and my review, and subscribe if you haven't, if you're new to the channel, and I'll see you for the Shakhtar preview. Ciao.